There's been all this fear of a consumer slowdown. Restaurants, kind of the front lines of that. What are you expecting from Darden?
Well, we're expecting earnings of 95 cents per share. That's 4 cents above the current consensus. Now, Darden has been a consistent outperformer since Gene Lee took over as CEO nearly 4 years ago, beating consensus nearly every quarter. I think this will continue to be the case today. What we're seeing from the consumer is, we're not seeing the fear just yet. If you look at some of the macro indicators, we look at the four-week moving average jobless claims, we look at real wages, still in quite positive territory, and that should augur well for the consumer, at least for the next 3 to 6 months. And I think, with some of the decline what we've seen across the restaurant universe, I think there are some bargains that are apparent as we see it.
Stephen, I'm curious. This is Kate Rogers here. I know there was a lot of excitement last quarter about some of the momentum around their back to basics offerings. Millennials are always a challenge, especially when it comes to casual dining. Do you think Darden is getting that right in the same way that maybe an Applebee's is in bringing in a younger consumer?
Oh, we think so. I think the what we're looking at is what Applebee's is doing now is what Darden, and particularly with Olive Garden, which accounts for 51% of the total sales, did about 3 years back, is that really focusing on core everyday menu value. And on top of that is a layer off-premise sales, which now accounts for 13% of Olive Garden's sales. So they're meeting the consumer where they are, and that's what millennials really want today.
There is a Seasons 52. That's their upscale concept near my house. I mean, at 5:30 on a Monday, it's packed. I mean, maybe it's just a one-off. I don't know how it's doing, but the thing seems crowded all the time. And if you walk in, Stephen, you'll think the economy is rocking. A lot of worries about the consumer lately. Anything that you're seeing from any of Darden's either geographic properties or concepts that indicates the U.S. economy is headed toward a recession or a major slowdown?
Not this time. In fact, if what you touched on with Season 52 is part of a larger upscale customer that Darden's pursuing, that's through their higher-end restaurant group, which includes Seasons 52, includes Capital Grille, Eddie V's, among others. That accounts for about 20% of the total sales. That's one of the reasons why we do expect a beat this quarter. The one thing we might be concerned about on the margins is that with the recent stock market volatility, how it will affect the fine dining brands like Capital Grille. But we'll see what happens. We'll see what management has to say.